Does my actual camera works? And
excellent.
And we are broadcasting.
Oh my god!
Yes.
Wait. Like actually, right now.
Yes.
My goodness.
My goodness. Hi, mom. Broadcasting to Facebook and Twitch also, so everything works.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh wait, I'm not seeing the Twitch stream.
I am seeing the stream.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Everything is working.
Very good, very good, very good. Okay, welcome to this Thursday stream of all streams.
Yeah.
And we're gonna talk.
Did we not do Thursday last week as well? I feel like we did.
Oh, you might be right. Yeah. Mm. I think so. There was a Friday stream also.
Maybe it was Friday last week, yeah.
Or maybe Friday.
I'm just trying to, because my schedule is not like a normal people's schedule, so.
Yeah, well.
It's hard to, stream always the same time.
Yeah. It's, in an ideal world, yeah, but, since this is not the ideal in the ideal world, we wouldn't be battling like a deadly virus and for this long, and
mm-hmm.
people
totally
yeah. And did you see COVID cases on the rise in the Baltic states?
I did.
Yeah.
How long until they start closing things down?
It's. I think some new restrictions tomorrow, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
What?
Not completely sure. Mostly try to stay out of the news, but I vaguely heard some new restrictions. Yeah, tomorrow. So. Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah.
Well, somebody will tell me tomorrow then.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah, exactly. You're breaking, literally breaking the law, and like, oh, shouldn't I do that or something? Yeah.
Come on, nobody's gonna like.
Yeah, well.
On the first day of new restrictions, nobody's gonna like. Whatever. I wear the mask everywhere, so.
Yeah.
And I am vaccinated, so it should be fine.
Oh, good. I think maybe it's the cable. I need to change the cable on this capture card. Maybe this is causing my freezings. But anyway. Cheers.
Yeah, I'm also drinking, but just water.
Yeah, I'm also drinking water, but
just good old water.
Yeah. Oh,
but is that other thing that you're drinking?
Coconut berry. Red Bull.
Is it new?
Every
once in a while they come up with like some new colors and new flavors.
I feel like this has been on the market for a while now.
I feel like Red Bull is the best one. It's just like the regular one, honestly. Sorry to be the purist, but...
The purist. Yeah, while drinking water. Alright, is the stream up? I don't stream...
Yeah, the Twitch one is up and running.
This is the weirdest thing. The stream appears of all places on YouTube, on my YouTube, in the history tab, where my previous, like, all my previous watchings, what I have previously watched.
Okay.
It comes up in the history tab first. That is the anyway. So weird. Why? But I don't question it. Anyway. You probably, or hopefully, came for some tech news. And I feel like today, this week, it's a good mix of you and, yeah, the world's tech news. Mostly, it hasn't been like that massive of a EU tech news, but still, there are some. But yeah, there's some new stuff that has been announced, and we're gonna talk about some, the HTC headset, the new
That's
one.
A while.
Yeah, and There's a new Apple event happening. And the new Google Pixel 6 is coming also in a week. And yeah. And some
autumn.
Okay, let's get into it, right? Bam. Okay, this actually worked this time. My webcam didn't freeze for some reason.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Surprising. All right,
I'm seeing German.
Yes. So the European tech news. So first of all, Germany technically it passed a law, right? I'm not completely familiar with when was this exactly, but anyway, the gist of it, the very fast conclusion is that Germany was basically like, okay, right to repair, right? That's a good thing. How about right to repair for software? So Germany basically is like, why does have right to repair only exist to only hardware, basically? So technically, this law, is there like a date where when this was like reinstated or something? Anyway, there's no date. Damn it. I need to find out the date. Anyway, technically, this German law will let you decompile the code and recompile it, technically, so to iron out any errors or any weird stuff that you might be finding into the code, and you have the right to do it, basically, which is really interesting. And I have no idea how about the implications exactly, because of course companies are not keen of giving away like their whole source code and stuff. But I need to find out more about this, because yeah, I just read about it briefly and I find it very fascinating. Can I find this in real time? What exactly happened there? Yeah, sorry for being so vague and but
so any person would be able to edit a code to a software that they own?
Technically that's what I'm getting at.
That sounds like a horrible idea though.
Yeah, that's true.
I can already think of like 10 different ways that it can be abused.
I mean, it's for basically the stuff you own. So if you want to brick your device, you can totally do that. But
but then it's not software then. You can own the softwares that have nothing to do with the hardware that you are using them on, like third-party softwares and programs. Video games, I guess, would fall under the same category, so you'd be able to legally edit. It's like modding, basically.
Mm-hmm.
But not really.
Yeah.
But also, what if you, like, change something with malicious intent and share it on the internet?
Well, everybody is sharing malicious stuff on the internet anyway, so that's not new. I guess people are constantly sending you all some kind of a links. Have you seen the latest in even the whole Apple community in Estonia is basically like, oh my God, what is this calendar filled with foreign links in the Facebook groups in Estonia? Basically, like I see this daily, multiple times, basically, like. Have you seen the iOS calendar overtake something? Okay. Links spam. Yeah, basically people are yeah, this is the solution, but the calendar spam basically is the problem. And every single person, at least I feel like every single person in Estonia has asked this question pretty much like already. Like their calendar is completely filled with some, yeah, like something like this basically, which is like all the non-techies are like, I didn't click on anything. What the hell is happening to my phone right now? And it's okay. So it's basically,
I don't have this problem, but
yeah, I don't have it either, but I feel like there's at least like 3 people daily asking this. But yeah, so that you can, the hacker, you can add, if you know the email of a person, I believe, then you already can add stuff on their calendar, basically.
Okay.
On iOS. Anyway. Yeah. Okay. Coming back to the thing here, if you're interested or like, then Google this, and I will Google this later also. And yeah, sorry for not being so prepared of, because yeah, this was also in only in German. I can't technically read German, but when was it exactly? The article completely fails to mention when was this. Anyway, seems interesting. Anyway, but
this is like a very arcane territory.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we still can't figure out the right repair for hardware. And we're already going to software.
Yeah, so. Yeah. The Germans already are, they're on it. They're breaking down. Okay, how about software? Why only hardware, basically, and stuff?
I mean, good for them.
Okay, but are you ready for some dystopian feature, basically? I don't know. We are entering some next level privacy concerns here, I feel like, with this one. Moscow Metro to roll out biometric ticket across entire network. They will scan your face to pay.
Okay.
So this was already in place in the summer? Yeah, when was it? Da-da-da... Reliable, wait, there was some kind of a mention of, yeah, four services, 1,000 registered passengers in the line 4 services in August, and expanding the pilot 7,000, and in the end of in October we will basically, the whole metro of Moscow will be face scans.
Okay.
Great. They call it face pay, by the way. 50,000.
Very interesting news.
I mean,
considering that recently I think I read that the EU wants to ban facial recognition.
Yeah. I
as a not like, you know, not like facial recognition on your phone, but like facial recognition usage for like law enforcement and such like that. Because it has like a negative effect on like profiling and things like that.
Yeah.
Like preventively, like, you know, profiling you for something you may do because you fit certain criteria.
Yeah.
But then, like, you know, doesn't mean anything. Mm-hmm. You know, just the algorithm. Yeah. So, which I kind of agree, honestly, with.
Yeah. But yeah, Moscow, right? So it's the Wild West. They can do whatever the F they want, pretty much. And oh man, tell me this database is not ending up in some kind of a Putin's hands, and they will like monitor all the oppositions who are like against the government, and then oh, we have all the faces. How easy.
I mean, they probably already have all the data. The KGB and stuff probably already has.
Yeah.
But everything they need, and probably political opposition in Russia doesn't drive undergrounds out of security concerns.
Yeah, imagine like being in a, I don't know, like not satisfied, like I don't know, yeah, being in an opposition. You're not happy with the way Moscow is, or Russia in general is ruled, and suddenly you lose your pass to travel. You cannot travel anymore. That's it. Your face is banned. Done.
I mean, this system is about as disturbing as the Amazon's grocery stores. I mean, it's basically the same thing.
Yeah, but this is like a, this is more like one specific grocery store so far. But yeah, if it would be like most grocery stores, then it would be like similar. But
it will. Just give it some years. We're already at the self-checkout. We were at the self-checkout many years ago. Now we are at the point where we have these BP devices.
BP.
You carry... is this a scientific term for that? Yeah.
Yeah.
That you carry with you that are connected to your card. Like Well, I don't know. I usually just shop at Coop. So like your Coop card, and you get your kind of own... basically like a cash, like, you know, scanner thing, so you don't have to interact with any people at all. And yeah, this is just the next logical step.
Yeah, but
give it like a decade and this is going to be in all the major grocery stores.
Yeah, but this is I feel like this is taking a way bigger step in terms of, this is like a public service, like this is losing, like, yeah, next year on the bus, the and I don't know. Anyway, yeah.
What if Estonia had this system for buses?
That would make me very uncomfortable.
It would. I guess the context is also is like different. I feel like if this was implemented in Estonian public transportation, people wouldn't go crazy about it, because Estonia is not Russia. And like, I mean, the public transportation in Estonia is already quite frictionless. You just like NFC your card to the turn. I don't know actually how public transportation works in other countries, but it's just like you beep your card at the entrance and there you go.
That's true.
So as long if you have it prepared before entering the bus, which most people do, you know, you just like enter immediately. But this is like, you know, this is like the only next step in terms of like, you know, extra convenience. You just enter, you know, you have your face that is connected to your bus ticket, which is already connected to your ID, I think.
Unless you have one of those Lenny Kravitz scarves wrapped around your head, and then you have to unwrap all the...
True. In the world of COVID, that is, could be problematic.
Yeah, exactly. But have you seen the...
Okay, then I have to ask, how is that going to work in Russian underground in the times of COVID? Because it's going to be the same exact thing.
You mean the mask thing?
No, yeah.
Oh, well, you have to take... you have to take off the mask, right?
Okay, so you should endanger public health and safety so that you can pay for your metro ticket. That's nice.
I mean, yeah.
I like that for Russia.
Okay. For example, in 5 years ago, I don't know, when entering US, you have to scan your face, which made me also uncomfortable. Which was like also like every single person has to scan your whole face and appearance and in addition to the fingerprints, by the way.
Americans are completely crazy with their security measures. You should be lucky that you are like super white, so they wouldn't have extra questions for you. Many people are not as lucky.
Yeah, true. Very true.
The privilege of whiteness.
Yep. Okay, continuing with some not so pleasant news, because Europe's car makers face raw material bottleneck for EV batteries. Yes, this has been going so basically, it's getting worse. And by the way, yeah, even the I just saw also an article, which is like a separate news, but I didn't include it. Used cars. They're selling used cars like nobody's business. Like every single like used car is basically like, okay, it's gone, it's done. Like it's a good to
Or they?
used car market sellers.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's basically. But yeah, where was the materials? Congo. Yeah. Congo is basically the for cobalt. Yeah, lithium basically comes from Australia and Chile, cobalt from Congo, and graphite from China. The largest processor of cathode and anode materials are located in China and Japan, basically. Yeah, so it's like not a huge surprise, but still Volkswagen. So basically, the European car market is like in deep doo doo. So Volkswagen can't get their materials, and cars are basically piling up all the parking lots, and they cannot fill the batteries into the cars. Anyway, yeah, just wanted to include basically, yeah, and also the raw material graphs. What the hell is going on right now? Crazy.
Shortages of everything.
Yeah, but anyway, there is some other form of transportation that William Shatner used this week, which was like, I don't know, was the biggest news I feel like in tech, I guess, or something. Oh, crap, I did something. Why is
No, something
Oh,
happened.
okay, no, don't worry. Yeah, so yeah, this was even on the Estonian news television going on. So yeah, Captain Kirk went to space, which makes him the oldest man who has been in space ever, basically. 90. Yeah, did you see this news?
I did not see this news.
Oh, okay.
I am getting a little bit tired of rich people going to space and telling us how it's cool. It's like, okay, no.
Yeah, I mean, it's not the most exciting thing, and it doesn't mean anything basically, but still.
I do find it kind of sort of cool that, like, we've gotten to the point where we can send a 90-year-old person to space and return them back without any health issues.
Yeah,
You know,
right?
so that's fun, but like, I feel like not every, like at this point, not every space journey of every person needs to be recorded in news every time. It's
True,
like, we get it. We
but
get it. Jeff was in space. Who else was in space? Some other.
Richard Branson also.
Yeah, Branson was in space. Like, I get it.
Yeah,
There's
yeah, yeah.
space.
But what if the rocket is phallic shaped? Do we
Aren't
is
all rockets
it
phallic shaped?
I don't know, not really. I feel like, okay, Blue Origin rocket is absolutely the, well, this was the rocket that oh my god. This is literally a penis.
Okay, that's funny.
But you haven't seen this?
That is the rocket that this guy went in. Okay, also I have to also ask.
Yes.
I have to ask though.
About the penis.
And I don't know about like this trend. This is the equivalent of like teenage TikTok trends, but like for very rich people.
Yeah, of course.
Like, how much environmental damage is done every time they decide to go in space
Oh.
like this?
Well,
like how much fuel is burned.
Yeah. You are, the answer is yes.
And I'm like, how is every like new hot thing that people seem to come up with also results in like severe environmental damage? Like NFTs, space travel, not even travel, it's just fucking space. What would be the equivalent? It's like an equivalent of like a very expensive bomber ride, basically.
Yeah.
Like a very expensive and also very like not environmentally friendly bomber ride. You know what I'm talking about? Bomber, like this attraction thing where like you, it's like a...
You mean the oh, this one. Okay, I meant like a bomber ride in the end. Yeah, okay, I see. I meant like a, for some reason, like a F-15 bomber, like a very fast, like hyper plane or something.
Ah, okay. Well, that's also probably expensive. But I mean, like the attraction park, you know, thing.
Yeah.
It's basically that. Not exactly, but you know.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. This is the ultimate flex, right? You can.
I mean.
That's why they do it.
As if there weren't any other ways that rich people could flex on the plebeians that follow them on social media.
Yes.
And like share and talk about how cool that is.
Yes.
It's like, I get it.
Wow.
I get it.
What is this? Speaking of bombers. What the hell? Jeff Bezos tweeted something? Amazon bomb? Okay, word. Anyway.
Amazon is now the first corporation to own a nuclear power.
Oh. Wait. Really?
I'm just kidding. Oh. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, my okay. God. That would be just the pinnacle of dystopian capitalist future.
Well,
imagine like, corporations owning a nuclear arsenal. I should write a book about it.
Well, he looks like a guy who owns a Uranus also, right? So I guess that's...
He totally looks like some kind of villain character from some kind of
weird
novel series that's just, gonna bomb people.
Yeah, so there it is. William Shatner, 90.
Ooh.
Anyway, let's move on to...
I also like how this article, the first one that you showed from Ars Technica, where he apparently said, it was a quote from him, that like everybody should experience this, right? So something like that.
Of course.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah.
The absolute vast majority of people will never experience this.
No.
Not even those living now, but even people living in the future.
Oh my God. You're breaking their heart.
Only the absolute, like, super rich people will be able to afford to have a leisurely trip to space and back. I mean, come on. Even the fucking civic aviation right today is, like, very expensive, you know?
Yeah.
Just like flying across this planet is very expensive and unaffordable for most people. So what are we talking about? Picnics in space.
Yeah. True. Oh my God. Tell me this is not a penis. Dear Lord.
Totally. This is the most exciting part of this story. Somebody had a very fun time designing this device.
Oh my God. Come on.
There has to be probably some scientific explanation for why most rockets look this way. But still, it's fun. maybe there is no explanation. It's just like people who just design these things, they think like to think like, oh, our phallic-shaped devices are going to be penetrating the outer space.
Yes.
And they just get off on this idea.
And you know what this is right here?
No. What's that?
Just a tip.
Moving on.
Yes.
The next story.
Yes, moving on. Very good. Keeping the theme of space, actually. Elon Musk is not the only one who's beaming internet from space, because Deutsche Telekom and Eutelsat is the, I believe, the owner of the satellites orbiting the Earth. But anyway,
okay.
Announced satellite broadband deal for rural Germany. Dun dun duh. So wherever the cable doesn't reach in rural Germany, there's a hope that you will get some space internet, which is very, very cool. Very cool.
Sure.
Yeah. No idea about pricing as yes, but this is, and this is not like announced yet, but this is coming. So Eutelsat Connect with a K has a total of 75 gigabits and capable of offering speeds up to 100 megabits per second.
Alright. Yeah, I guess satellite internet could be a fun solution to, for like large countries with large like rural areas where like it's just not feasible to to stretch broadband connection everywhere.
Yeah, so
sure.
That's
fun.
Can I damn it. I wanna
Also, that rural German landscape that you're showing right now looks very nice. I would like to go there.
Yeah, right?
Mm-hmm. Like looks lovely.
Like some purple Milka cows and some, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, straight out of like some advertisement for like some Swiss chocolate artisanal company making thing.
Yeah, big boobed women bringing you some...
in like a... like national
garments. Drindle, it's called
Kringles.
Drindle is the outfit of the women
carrying freshly baked
pretzels and some
beer,
good old beer. Yes, absolutely. But yeah, so if you're in Germany and then by the way, not only in Germany, the satellite covers the whole of Germany, yes, but along with 14 other European countries. So
okay,
we'll see.
So
there is some
they'll offer these plans to outside of Germany.
Well, they just announced we have the capability. Well, they basically said that they reached a deal. The Deutsche Telekom and Eutelsat are gonna work together. So blah blah blah.
Sure.
Actually, they're mentioning some other countries. Yeah, here. Following agreement, Orange in France. Yeah, they need to. Yeah, Orange in France, TIM in Italy. Might be also, if they Orange and TIM might reach also a deal, and why not? Satellite internet. Yes. Anyway, let's move on to HTC announcing some insect goggles, I feel like, or something, I don't know. Man, this looks so weird. Why does it have to be like
a... It's definitely a look, yeah.
Yeah, dear Lord. This is...
So is there a take on like Oculus Quest or something?
Yes. So was it I think it was both AR and VR, because that's why it's so that's why it's quite so big. It's like VR game. Where was it? The because there is another device coming also, which is the Motion Leap, which is only for AR, but I'm pretty sure this is all, this is just VR maybe then. Okay, yeah. I'm seeing all VR only here. So yeah, but basically the consensus of the internet so far is basically this is not gonna be so good. Because this price tag suggests also it's more like a budget VR option. So, and the HTC hasn't been the cutting edge in terms of VR also. That would be Valve. Valve has basically the best headset right now on the market. And HTC has a decent one, yes, but not the best one. But and yeah, so
well, I mean,
this is not even the flagship price tag, also. So the $499.
Yeah, well, I mean, Oculus Quest is also cheap, but it's also the most popular, probably, VR headset.
Oculus Quest is very, very good. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, but the funny thing
it's
is,
it's also not like a flagship device, you know.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. Yes, yes, absolutely. But the lens, yeah, it's more like a bang for buck situation. But HTC hasn't been like showing like a best bang for buck, basically. So, and the 75 frames per second is like okay, yeah. So 1.6K per eye, which is like okay, it's basically okay. So it's not like Qualcomm XR1 is like okay, yeah, technically also it's not like Facebook's discontinued Oculus Go. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe the looks will set it apart from the Facebook offerings, and if people want to go for some kind of a, what do you call this? Like a space traveler who needs also to weld something.
I don't know who would possibly buy a VR headset based on looks.
I
guess if they are offering like a okay device but still it costs $500, I guess yeah, it's like
Imagine this having like a commute, like watching like I don't know, TV show on your 30-minute commute to somewhere, and yeah, big screen TV, right? No, that would
theoretically yes.
It's,
I have never seen a single person using VR in public, but theoretically, yes.
Well, VR is very, 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 very niche, basically. That's why.
Yeah.
So it's still
I think this device is going to change this.
I mean, they are trying, so.
No, yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Kudos to them.
Yeah, you have to try, right?
Yeah, totally.
But because the even the Facebook thing, Facebook Oculus Go is more like not like glasses, Quest 2, I mean, it's more like a still a headset, basically.
Yeah.
So it's like and they want to go the angle of it's like just big sunglasses or something. That's I feel like that's the angle.
Sure.
So to make it more like friendlier. So
it's still looks ridiculous. I wouldn't necessarily say that it looks less ridiculous than a traditional VR headset.
Yeah, but we are also both not VR enthusiasts as of yet. So
I'm just waiting for the PlayStation VR 2 to come out. I'll buy that thing.
Okay.
I already decided. Yeah.
Really? Okay. Okay.
Yeah, totally. I tried VR once and it was fine.
Mm-hmm.
But I think not only is PlayStation like on Sony, I guess, working on a PSVR 2, they're also, I think, are quite significantly investing in VR games.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'm moderately interested. There already are games that are like worth playing.
Camera died.
But there'll be more. I don't think VR is the future of video games, honestly, because until VR is like a completely frictionless process, think like, I don't know if you've seen that, like a Black Mirror episode where they just like have some chips integrated into their heads.
Yeah.
And then they fall asleep and play VR games.
Yeah,
until
yeah.
It's that, I mean, it's not gonna replace traditional video games.
Yeah.
But it's like an extra thing that you can do.
Yep.
Like, probably horror would be an amazing outlet for VR.
I have seen some videos about horror games. Like, people cannot. Basically, it's just straight up too horrifying to play, basically, the horror games.
Yeah.
They were just just take off and fuck this and everything and no.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, absolutely. That if you want to have, like, this makes me, I haven't tried, of course. Yeah, like horror games, basically, but.
Yeah, me neither.
I completely agree. I completely believe, basically, that this will be, like, straight up way more immersive and way more horrifying, basically. And if you're into horror, then this is the way to go.
Yeah, a good headset that doesn't take a million cords to connect to your hardware.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, the new PSVR is supposed to have only one cord, one USB-C cord that will just, like, work, which is good enough, I guess.
Yeah.
Mixed with decent controllers and a 3D audio headset.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you got yourself some pant-shitting horror experiences,
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, exactly. And you buy like a mouse bungee cord that will hang from the ceiling.
Yeah, of course, you gotta have a bungee cord now.
Yeah, exactly. That
can't not have it, yeah.
Yeah, so the cord doesn't tangle you or something.
Yeah,
it holds the cord. Yeah, exactly. That's the way to go. I don't know. Yeah, we'll see. Okay. Yeah. Do you know when the PlayStation VR launches?
No
idea. Okay, yeah,
but they already show the controllers for it.
Okay,
which makes me believe, okay, well, thinking logically, it would probably be a holiday season,
yeah,
of some year, and I feel like it would already be announced
of some year
if it was coming this year.
Okay,
you know, that kind of makes sense.
I think so, yeah.
It's already like mid-October. So maybe holiday 2022, then, like, the next winter.
Sure.
The next winter or the next November, maybe.
PSVR 2, release date, blah, blah, blah. 20 days ago, is there like a day? But rumors surrounding the systems we'll hear more in early 2022, yeah.
Early 2022.
Early 2022, even.
Maybe.
Maybe. I don't know.
I don't think it matters particularly, honestly. I feel like companies very much overestimate the importance of release dates for hardware. You know, it's fine. If people want it, they'll buy it. If people don't want it, it's fine. So, like, Nintendo Switch came out in March. Who buys shit in March? Still the best-selling console.
Yeah.
So, it's fine.
Yeah. I don't know. All right. Yes?
On the note of Nintendo Switch, like, now, Estonian retailers are selling the OLED model for, like, 400 euros.
Yeah. It was, like, a $50 price bump, right, in the US, but in Estonia it's like probably more. Right,
yep.
So I don't know.
I mean, I got a PS5 for that money, so it's just not worth it.
400,
even more than, okay, they're selling even more than 400.
Oh, come on, 1 euro more and you could have 420. Come on.
Ugh.
You're not.
420 is actually, no, 430. 430 was the price of PS5 that I got for. But, like, that is a PS5 and this is a freaking Switch.
Yeah.
I decided that, I mean,
come on. Is there a 421? Come on. 419 everywhere.
Like, Switch OLED seems like a nice thing. But yeah, it's not enough of an upgrade. Even though I do play in handheld quite often.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not enough. Especially with the price increase, it's like...
Yeah. Okay.
If they release some cool special edition console with some like limited edition, I don't know, game or something, like physical game,
maybe. Yeah.
But at that point, may as well wait for
next
Switch.
The OLED pixel refresher game that you need to refresh your OLED screen not to get like OLED burning, right?
Oh yeah,
that's the
I'm
game.
Pretty sure they're not using like the cutting edge OLED panels for the Switch, so I am quite confident that we are gonna see some stories about burn-in sooner or later.
Yeah, yeah. All right, shall we move on to some Apple stuff? There's a new event happening. Yes, the 18th of October, and my camera keeps freezing. Damn it.
I quite like this logo for the Apple event.
Yeah, I don't know, kind of fitting in terms of William Shatner goes to space this week, and this week also like
the entire presentation is going to be not about like new products but about how Tim Cook went to space as well. And he's going to spend an hour talking about how amazing it is.
Actually, I got there like half an hour before Captain Kirk and William Shatner, so yeah.
And they're going to announce the launch of their iRocket or something like that.
Yes.
And instead of looking like a penis, he's going to have like a perfectly like...
vagina.
No, it's going to be like a perfectly like smooth, like cylindrical shape. So it's going to look more like a vibrator.
Oh, okay. Yes. And charges via lightning.
Via MagSafe.
Via MagSafe.
Gigantic MagSafe.
Fancy. Okay, okay.
Oh, yeah, I mean, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, so what are we looking at? What is this event?
I don't know. Unleashed. But, well, all the people are basically saying like MacBooks and AirPods. The new AirPods, right?
AirPods,
I don't know, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to ask what you think is going to be announced, if it's just going to be just good old MacBooks or...
Yeah, I feel like, here it is. 14 and 16-inch MacBook Pros.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
Maybe the Mac Mini?
Mac Mini Pro?
Mac Mini Pro? Or Mac... Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, that would be cute.
Ooh, yeah. That would be something... The Mac Mini Pro.
M1X Mac Mini. I don't think they have to call it Mac Mini Pro. That's just stupid. But like M1, just a Mac Mini with a M1X chip. Yeah, totally. Why not?
Yeah, I can do that. Yeah, but yeah, the and the AirPods Gen 3.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Most likely will be
not
also
the Pro, but just like the good old regular AirPods.
I feel like this is gonna be just a regular AirPods 3, basically. I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, which is, or maybe the Pro also, AirPods AirPods Pro 2 maybe.
But then like,
I don't know.
Probably the new AirPods will probably have the same shape as the old ones, right?
You mean the AirPods 2? AirPods Pro 2?
Yeah.
Maybe. I don't know.
So if they announce the new Pros at the same time as the new 3s, which are supposed to look like Pros, basically.
Yeah.
I feel like it's going to be a little bit weird.
Okay.
But yeah, I think Gen 3 AirPods sounds like a good bet.
One particular fan of ours, Melissa Mand, is, so what new products are they gonna announce? ? So I think she is getting a little bit too optimistic about some new Apple products, because she got a new MacBook yesterday.
She did?
Yes, I gave her my old one.
Ah, okay. I was like, oh, the M1.
Yeah, no, not yet. Not yet.
Something?
Not yet. But yeah, basically she went from a 2015 MacBook Pro to a 2016 MacBook Pro.
Okay. That's an upgrade, I guess.
I mean, yeah, it's the old with the old ports with the completely new touch bar, Thunderbolt, both 15 inches. So yeah, I mean, yeah, and she's already missing her Type A USB port because
Really?
she, yes, because she uses a mouse, and she now you has to use a dongle because,
Yeah, welcome to the dongle life.
yep, welcome to the dongle. Someone's old, someone's old, someone's new. Very nice. Yeah, that's how it is. But yeah, eventually the plan is to upgrade also her to M1. But yeah,
Yeah.
I'm when the time comes, when there's a good price for some M1, then
I've been trying to find what was announced on the previous Mac event, and I'm struggling. My memory is betraying me.
From my iPads, iPad mini, iPad regular, iPhones and Apple Watch
No,
and
that was the previous event that I remember. I mean, like
yeah.
the event when they announced the M1 MacBook Air and Pro. What was announced?
I see what you mean. Okay. Ooh.
Was that just it? M1 MacBook Air and Pro? I feel like there had to have been something more, but at the same time, it was kind of like a big event.
20. Oh.
2020 was like what? October 2020.
Yeah.
September 2020, October 2020.
October. Apple event, blah blah blah. Macworld. Was it California streaming? New AirPods. Wait. This is some rumors.
No, this is like the new event. Yeah, it's very hard. Like, it's as if like the 2020 events never happened. Like, it's impossible to find anything about the 2020 event.
Expectations, blah blah blah.
Ah, maybe. Maybe. Wait, was it? I think it may have been also AirPods Max was also the same event.
No, I
No.
don't think so. I feel like that was like in the summer somewhere.
Oh.
I feel like.
Ugh, time is difficult.
Oh, was it? Oh, I was gonna say HomePod Mini, but I'm not sure now. Maybe, but okay. I guess it doesn't matter right now. There's another Apple-related news right now. Apple quietly extends the AirPods Pro repair program that addresses crackling and static. So yes, I think we both did replace the your. You did replace your AirPods also, right? Or did you? It I know that.
I replaced one of my AirPods,
Yeah, okay. I did what I did mine also. So
yeah.
and Apple extended this program actually.
Yeah, I'm quite mixed on the AirPods Pro, honestly.
Really, quite mixed. Okay. What? Yeah. So
I don't know, I just feel like
you don't
this
like them
kind of
anymore?
I mean, they're fine. I just feel like I've been having a lot more issues with them than I would like from an Apple product, honestly.
True. There is one hugely annoying issue for me with my Mac Mini M1. I don't know what it is. I have multiple software updates I have been doing, and sometimes it's not always, but it's like it has gotten better with software updates, but
Okay.
sometimes it just play. I connect them, play music 10 seconds, then they disconnect.
Interesting.
And then they connect again.
Which is sometimes like, their headphones get confused when you are like
using
multiple devices at once.
Yes, I know
so
that.
So you have them like connected to a computer, and then you like take your phone, like open your phone, and then it's like, oh, which one do I connect to? You know.
Yeah, and I have been switching off the Bluetooth menu on my phone, which sometimes helps, but sometimes it just straight up disconnects from the Mac Mini and doesn't connect to anything anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And then a restart has helped also. So it's very weird. It's like not all the time. It's like, I don't know, 30% of the times, maybe 20 or something. It does that right now.
Yeah, totally.
And it gets better with software updates, I feel like. But it's not quite gone yet. So I don't know. We'll see. Do you have something similar going on or?
Well, I had that crackling noise issue for a while, which apparently fixed itself.
Yeah.
Because that's what happens nowadays.
Yeah.
And other than that, I guess they are fine. Unfortunately, I don't use my headphones very often anymore because I can't listen to anything at work, and I mean, at home I don't really use headphones. Very rarely, maybe, when I'm like listening to a podcast, which I also don't do very much anymore because,
life.
But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm like, yeah.
So. Yeah.
No, that's all I have to say. I'm like not like 100%, you know, satisfied with my AirPods Pro experience.
Okay, yeah, that's fair. Yeah, same here, pretty much. I'm kind of thinking if there would be like an AirPods Max, I would go for it. But yes,
There are AirPods Max.
Yeah, there are AirPods Max. Yes, absolutely. But the price is just no.
Spicy price.
But yeah, the price. I don't think I will buy them because they will not come down to, I don't know.
Yeah.
For example, totally. €200. That would be. I feel like that's. I have bought €200 headphones, which are these exact ones. These were 200, and if they would come down to 200, then yes. But there will be a new AirPods Max, whatever cheaper one, and
probably
most likely I will get that one
with a better case. But we should answer the question that Melissa was asking about what's going to be announced.
Oh,
what is going to be announced?
Well,
what do you think?
Well, yeah, the
14-inch MacBook Pro.
14-inch MacBook Pro, 16-inch
MacBook Pro.
Gen 3 AirPods. AirPods 3, not the AirPods Pro, but the AirPods 3. And maybe a Mac Mini, the small computer that I have. It's with the M1X processor, so
I feel like it's a no-brainer, but I feel like maybe they won't do it. Although it kind of feels like a wasted opportunity not to. So then I have to question for you, are they going to announce these new colorful MacBook Airs?
Ooh, MacBook Airs. Yeah. Ooh, that's a good question. I don't know. Oh, yeah, Apple has been doing the color thing with the iMacs now, and
People already like made a million renders of the new MacBook Airs on.
Yeah, and the MacBook Air.
They keep like these rumor mill YouTubers keep like reiterating this rumor that like the new MacBook. Well, I mean, they say that it's not gonna be announced this year. It's gonna be like mid 2022, which I also think probably because they don't want to probably like take the spotlight away from the M1X reveal, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But they keep reiterating this weird rumor that it's gonna have like a sub 1080p resolution at 120Hz refresh rate. And I'm like, no.
What?
There's absolutely no way that Apple would release a sub 1080p computer in 2022.
No. That's
especially considering that current MacBook Air has like a...
That's a hard
1440p plus, basically.
Yeah, that's a hard no for me also.
There's absolutely no way.
Yeah, the rumor, I saw a rumor also that the MacBooks could have now the iPad screen, the mini LEDs.
Yeah, the mini LED.
Mm-hmm. Mini LED, that could be an exciting thing to have on a MacBook, honestly. But yeah.
Okay, then I have to ask another question.
Yeah?
So we're on the same page. Probably there's going to be no MacBook Air this event.
I don't think so, yeah. Because I don't see the... Because this event will be about M1X, right? I don't see they are putting the M1X in a MacBook Air and...
No. The new MacBook Air probably is going to have an M2.
Yeah, next year somewhere.
Yeah. So we are on the same page.
I think so.
Okay, yeah. Then I have to ask you another question. Is the MacBook Pros, or the new MacBook Pros that they announce, are they also going to have a redesign?
Ooh.
And I'm talking not about like an extra port here or like a card reader there. I'm talking like a significant visual redesign.
I mean, define significant, but I feel like they're gonna be like a boxy shape. But I would suspect they will be thicker this time around, and I'm hoping for the because. To me, the pattern seems like that all the rumors that has been usually floating around, like, oh, the MacBook Pro is getting an HDMI port and SD card slot. This was over a year ago, basically. The same with the iPhones and the same with the Apple Watch, basically. So the all the rumors are basically technically 2 years away that we are getting right now. So it's like... Since we didn't get the SD card and the HDMI slot on the MacBooks yet, I think this is it. I think now they will finally release the... And the watch also, the boxy watch, it will come the next year. The MacBooks now, and what was the third one? The iPhone with the without the notch, this will, and maybe portless, this will also come next year, basically. So it's like, so it's Apple is slower than the rumors, I feel like. And this a lot, I think, I'm pretty sure this MacBook will have an SD card and an HDMI slot port, and
And also like a redesign,
and
right? Like a more square.
Yes, it's gonna be hopefully a little bit thicker, I believe, and more battery and stuff. And redesigned, boxy, even more boxy design, like the iPad boxy.
Okay.
I feel like that's .
Yeah, I kind of agree. When they announced the M1 MacBooks, they didn't redesign them at all because they wanted to focus on the hardware, which I feel like was the... I mean, it would have been nice, of course, if they just like did the whole thing, but I feel like it was the right thing to do because...
Mm-hmm.
I mean, everybody was talking about the chip, you know? I feel like if they redesigned the laptops as well, people would be like, okay, well, you know, they redesigned it, but also look at the chip, you know?
Yeah.
It's like destroying all the competitors and stuff like that. But now that we already know what M1 is, and if, I am sure that M1X is going to be very disruptive.
It's going to be good. I believe so, yeah. They had some time now to refine
if
it.
like if like Intel were concerned about the M1 chips, I am quite confident that the M1X is gonna, yeah.
It's gonna bitch slap.
But yeah, I also feel like they will also make present a new design this year along with the new M1X chip. Blow everybody away. The reception is super positive. The benchmarks are insane. People are going crazy. And apparently, they are supposed to be performing like desktop grade CPUs. You know, like the M1X chips,
Yeah, we'll see,
which is crazy.
yeah.
I usually Apple don't really like lie about these things very much. I mean, in marketing, they are, you know, they don't report the whole truth, but when it comes to the actual like measurements and benchmarks, usually it's pretty close
Yeah,
to
exactly.
what they claim. And yeah, and the new redesign is just gonna be, you know, cherry on top. It's just gonna become the hottest laptop, you know, we can get.
Yeah, and maybe the Mac Mini also.
And Mac Mini as well. Yeah, I don't know
Oh
if Mac
man.
Mini needs a redesign. I mean, it's quite an elegant like box.
Oh, it needs a redesign.
I mean, it could be smaller, yeah, because it has a lot of wasted space. But as far as like the design language, I feel like it actually kind of fits the current Apple design language. You know, it's very like sharp angles and, you know, rounded corners, and yeah, just the size could be smaller.
Absolutely. That's yeah, exactly. Like just this, but smaller. That would be enough for me.
And then next year they will announce the colorful MacBook Airs with the M2 chip that is gonna be, you know, better than M1, but not by much. But also will come with a new design, the same like idea as the Pros, the new Pros, but also in all the cool colors. And everybody's happy. And they ditch the MacBook line, just like naked MacBook line. Because who cares about that?
Some basic bitches.
That's just completely pointless.
Who wants to who basically want to browse Facebook and Instagram? That's what it's for.
But that's the thing, like if they announce a MacBook, like just a random, like a regular MacBook, it will still be with M1. You know? They're not gonna release a new Intel MacBook.
That's true.
But we already know that M1 can do a lot more things than, you know, browse Reddit and send emails. So I feel like MacBooks just become obsolete. I feel like they could also rebrand MacBook Air as the MacBook, you know?
Although they're leaning into the Air also, because with the iPad Air now.
True. But also, there is no more air in iPad Air. It doesn't have a fan.
I don't
So,
know, yeah, what they're,
yeah.
yeah, is it, yeah, it, like MacBook Max or something? I don't know. They're gonna be like the MacBook Air will be become the MacBook Pro, and the MacBook Pro will become the MacBook Max or something. I don't know.
Oh, you know, that sounds awful.
That sounds awful,
We don't need
and
maxes. I feel like we need less maxes and less pros in tech.
true. I completely agree.
And definitely Pro Max should not exist. Like they should change the name for iPhone Pro Max. That is just funny. And that's a different thing. Yeah, but I feel like it's gonna be like a short and sweet presentation about M1X MacBook Pros. And then the next day the coverage is gonna start. People are gonna go crazy.
Of
Yeah.
course.
I do not see like the coverage for these new MacBooks being bad or even like, you know, skeptically like neutral.
Yeah, fair. Yeah, we'll see. I believe that they're gonna be good. Yeah, there's no doubt, pretty much.
The other thing is the price.
Yeah.
The price is going
But
to
yeah.
be, yeah.
That's what I'm afraid of. That's what will keep me on my M1 Mac Mini for some years, probably, because I believe if they're gonna put the M1X in a Mac Mini, then they're gonna at least 1,000 US dollars, mm-hmm. basically, instead of the $699 that my Mac Mini was going mm-hmm. for. And yeah, I am really happy with my Mac Mini M1 right now, so I don't see
same any. Here.
Yeah.
But if they actually release the colorful MacBook Airs next year and they actually nail the design and colors,
okay,
I will be tempted.
Yeah. Okay.
Like some beautiful, like, I don't know, if they use a similar sort of like color science as they did with the iMacs.
Mm-hmm.
Like the orange looks very good.
Yeah.
And the purple looks very good.
They look good, yeah. Orange mm-hmm. Looks the best, I feel like, also, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, funny. You're into more like a design upgrade, and I'm more into like performance upgrade. I mean
my current laptop was already like a big performance upgrade compared to previous ones, and I mean if it's M2 on it, so it's gonna be better than M1, you know. That's just mm-hmm. you know, they're gonna go on the stage and do the whole spiel about how it's the best processor we were created, you know, how mm-hmm. Apple likes to present their products. But yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I just know that I don't really need like a M1X
there's a mosquito laptop
in my life right now.
Yep.
And I really like the keyboard, like you know, just like the bottom
mm-hmm.
like, you know, the base half of the MacBook Air design that is like a sloped.
Yeah.
I think it's definitely the optimal shape compared to like the Pro models. So yeah, I feel like I don't need them more than air in my life.
Yep. All right. Shall we move on to some non-Apple stuff? The Pixel 6, by the way. So many leaks all over the internet already. Like the Pixel 6 is like, you're literally like, know what the hell you're getting if you want the Pixel 6, basically, because yeah, it just. The marketing site for Pixel 6 confirms it's 30 watts of charging and 80% faster performance from the Tensor Core, the in-house chip, by the way. Yeah, if you're the Pixel line is getting also their own M1 SoC, the in-house chip, Apple has
the
been
A series.
Well, yeah, the A, like. Yeah, the iPhone A series or something. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So
the G series.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. And looks pretty good. So from the marketing materials,
I'm quite skeptical that Google will be able to nail it on the first try. Like, look at fucking Samsung. They still haven't managed to figure out their own Exynos line and how many years they've been, you know, iterating.
Yeah, I don't know.
So, like, imagining that they will just, on the first go, just release a chip that is better than Snapdragon's. It's like...
Yeah.
Okay. Sure.
True, true, true. It doesn't, like... But I feel like Google is in a better camp than Samsung in terms of, like, optimizing for... hardware, I feel like.
Sure.
Definitely. The best example of that would be the camera of the Pixel lineup. It's very well optimized for the camera, basically. But yeah, we'll see. Who knows? But yeah, 120 hertz refresh rate, 6.7 mm-hmm. inch panel. And yeah, 120 hertz. 30% of recycled plastics, and honestly, yeah, the Pixel line to me, if I wouldn't be on iPhone, I think Pixel would be the phone to get for me. That's, I have said that many times, but yeah, I have never used a Pixel phone, but from all the coverage of people that I have seen, the Pixel. Either the Pixel or the OnePlus phone, basically. OnePlus something.
It is. Well, funny you should say that, because the latest rumors suggest that the new OnePluses are going to be, like, way more... Way more. Wait, what did they merge with?
Way more Oppo.
Oppo, yeah, way more Oppo and way less OnePlus, especially when it comes to software.
Okay.
So that is unfortunate. I don't know if that was the wise decision, because I feel like the Oxygen OS was definitely a more elegant software than Color OS.
I agreed. I think, yeah, I think.
But like the recent, the more recent OnePlus has got a new update for, you know, new firmware updates. And people who have more recent OnePluses say that it basically looks like a Color OS.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely an interesting choice. But yeah, I find it also very ironic that, like, how should I say it? It's like, people always get a lot of shit to Apple for, like, oh, you know, you're creating this ecosystem, walled garden, blah, blah, blah. You know how it goes.
Yeah.
But then, like, you know, you ask a a tech YouTuber or a content creator about, like, you know, what phones they use, and there's a very high degree of probability that it's going to be a Pixel phone. Which is basically, you know, they're basically, like, Google are basically doing the same as Apple are doing.
Especially yeah.
with their in-house chips.
Yeah, and Microsoft also. Yeah.
And Microsoft, yeah. So they're all starting to do the same thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's, well, that's how you make the most money, right?
Yep,
that's why they're doing it pretty much, yeah. Of course, yeah, if you're not into the walled garden, I guess. Have you seen, for example, the...
And that's what I'm saying, like, Google a couple years, 2-3 years, and they're going to have the exact same walled garden as Apple does. With their in-house silicon, with their, like, control over all the manufacturing processes, R&D, software, everything. Yeah. And be the exact same thing.
Well, yeah, because... At the end of the day, what do they care most about? Money. And mm-hmm. that's what makes the most money. If you're mm-hmm. like locking into your own system, then yeah. Have you seen, by the way, have you seen the Fairphone?
No.
Really? Yeah. That's like the, yeah, that's...
Oh, wait.
That's basically the absolute... opposite of walled garden.
Yeah,
that's basically the was it from Europe? I think that's it's from Europe also, right?
It looks very OnePlus-esque,
That is, I noticed that also. Yeah But that's basically a phone that you can upgrade the battery, everything. Like, it's very very if you want to have like a conscious buying choice, this is the phone for the conscious people, basically. Like even the materials are basically mined. Like, that's the fair part of the fair phone. It's very the workers are paid fairly, and even all the materials are sourced. Very responsible, basically, and stuff. So that's the fair phone. But yeah, it's okay. It's not like a flagship, but it has, it's 579 euros. And it's
okay.
It's all right. Video is 4K 30. 48 mega, 6 gigs of RAM, 8 core, no, octa, 6 core. And Android 11, Gorilla Glass 5, 6.3 inches, IPS. It's all right. But yeah, this is basically the opposite, absolute opposite side of Apple or Google or whoever, if you want to have want to upgrade your phone, actually. Like, you can remove the back very, very easily. And,
oh my god, how many years has it been since you could remove backs on phones?
Yeah.
That being said, I mean, I don't particularly miss that. I mean, you know, this is a phone for conscious people, but also I'm very consciously aware that, you know, I am very deep in Apple's web.
Same here.
But I'm also voluntarily in it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It would be a hassle to get out of it, and, you know.
Oh, yeah.
But, like, how should I say it? It would be one thing if it was, like, oh no, I'm like stuck in the Apple's ecosystem and I can't get out, and there's like a whole like bright world of endless opportunities out there, it would be like one thing. But
yeah,
it's all the same.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly. All the companies. It's just that like probably every tech company that is at all like relevant and meaningful nowadays, they wish that they could do what Apple does with their products.
Yeah.
And many of them want to and try to.
Oh, so yeah.
Like companies like Google.
Of course. Yeah.
So it's fine. It's
yeah.
fine. The world is ending, so
yeah.
I feel like it's fine.
They want
it
to
doesn't
make...
matter what ecosystem you're in.
Yeah, exactly. All right, let's move on to some completely some other topic. because I like to talk about some future stuff. Wanna see the future? Germany.
The future's future. So much Germany this
yeah,
time.
Yeah, okay, there's a... Was there two? Okay, maybe this is three. Okay, anyway, Germany has this thing now. Trucks that are basically trams. Which is like, what? Okay. So yeah, they're building, like they're testing right now to some electric trucks. Because, yeah, why not? Sustainable.
Okay.
And clean energy, right? So...
Sure.
That's very, very cool looking. And it can basically be like, yeah, driverless. This is how we get driverless trucks, which is very exciting to me, at least. It will just hook into the electrical system and it will just drive a given path back and forth and problem solved. We just won global, the global CO2 war, basically. And, okay, there's one more. Sweden, not to be outdone, Sweden is doing their own thing, basically. Smartroad Gotland. So Gotland is a island on in Sweden, and they're doing like wireless charging trucks now. That is pretty cool. So opening up the road and preparing the trench. So they open up a trench. They install like charging coils. So MagSafe, basically. They literally install MagSafe into the roads.
Okay.
They repaving the roads, basically. And yeah, you will have like a wireless charger for trucks now. And so here's a before and after. Yeah, really cool. So yeah, the trucks, I believe they have been tested, but there's no video about it as of right now. This was the only video I can find. But yeah, I find this very exciting. So climate crisis who? Anyway.
Yeah, it's funny that we live in the universe where like these news can exist at the same time as like, you know, commercial space flights for rich people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so we're doing something to save the planet, but also a lot of other things that definitely do not save the planet.
Yeah, awesome. All right. Also, one other weird stuff that I saw on you can visit the Wall of China in Google Maps.
Ah, okay.
Ooh. So, yeah, because traveling is out of the question as of right now, pretty much. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, now you can take like a walk on the Chinese wall. I don't know.
It's so overgrown.
It is.
I thought it was like a nicely maintained.
It's so long. It has basically probably everything. So it's like,
yeah.
But yeah, so this was very overgrown for some reason. But yeah, this is like, here it's way mm-hmm. way better. Yeah, the Chinese Wall. Never been.
That's cool.
But if
same.
In case you're interested, Google Maps has it now. So. You can...
It looks like a wall.
Yeah, exactly. And that's what
And
you.
it looks pretty great, so
Yeah.
the name checks out.
Yeah, it checks out, right? Yeah. Anyway, let's move on to meme break.
Yay! We're
Yes.
done with the serious stuffs.
I feel like, yeah. So I feel like this was my favorite meme this week. I mean, oh, love it. Anyway, the Loch Ness monster. Also, whatever this is.
What? Is this supposed to be with sound?
Oh yeah. So yeah,
Okay.
sorry. You can you can't hear the sound again. But
Yeah,
yeah, it's
but the
a
stream can, yeah?
yeah, the stream
Okay,
can.
excellent.
But yeah, the woman is basically screaming, 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 and then
What is that? Is that just a
duh!
slope?
I don't, it's a
Or like a...
garage some sort.
Oh,
And
a garage. Okay.
yeah, and the two women, for some reason, they decided to skate down this garage for some reason, although they clearly could
And it's
can't.
closed, yeah?
Yeah, it is closed. Yeah, there's a loud thump at the end, and I'm a horrible person basically. Anyway, so this week I'm gonna recommend some I don't know, disco, because yeah, KC and the
Oh,
Sunshine Band.
disco?
And yeah, I've been this week I've been listening to so much disco because KC and the Sunshine Band, and also Earth, Wind and Fire. Oh my God, Boogie Wonderland, damn, some good stuff. Yeah, Sway and I'm Crazy About You, and yeah. Oh, by the way, Here Comes the Sun by Womack Womack. This was one of the I didn't know. Yeah, Here Comes the Sun, by the way, is from the Beatles, and but yeah, they did cover. Bobby Womack, and man, so good. Anyway, go listen to some disco. So anyway, let's Squid Game. As I understand, my lo lovely co-host and friend has been watching the Squid Game, eh?
Yeah, I have been watching Squid Game. I'm about halfway done with the show.
Yeah. Oh wow. Halfway done. What? How many?
It's very bingeable. Definitely, I feel like, yeah,
Okay.
you could definitely watch it very quickly.
Oh,
So it's
it's.
nine
Oh
episodes.
yeah. 9 episodes. Okay.
It's a Korean drama, I guess. It's like,
Yeah. What?
It's like most of the time it's hard to take it seriously because of how ridiculous it is. But also in certain parts of the show it gets really dark real quick. And when they give like backstory to characters. So basically the idea is, I mean, all of that is the first episode, so I guess I'm not gonna spoil that much. Is that the main character is like a basically just a failure. Like a middle-aged man who lives here with his mom in Seoul, I think. I think they live in Seoul. But not be but like, I mean, at first I thought like, okay, well maybe he's taking care of her, but basically he's like worthless, you know. He doesn't have a steady job. He spends all his money that he gets on gambling. He owes people, like some shady people, lots of money. They got divorced. His daughter is like moving away, so you know, life is not going great. And basically he gets invited by some random person in the underground to participate in some kind of game to win a lot of money. Like a game show, basically. And yeah, that's basically the idea of the show. They get kidnapped and placed in some place. I don't know where. I mean, it's probably spoilers, yeah. So some place. And they are then, well, they're not forced. They sign a agreement, you know, that they're going to participate in the game. But they don't know exactly what's gonna happen. So they sign up to the game that says that they can't quit once they start. And they're like, well, you know, we're gonna lose and, you know, whatever. But if we win, we're gonna win lots of money. And they play like children's games, like hopscotch and tug of war.
Okay, my question is, yeah, because I guess spoilers again, I don't know. Do they know that they're gonna be killed if they lose?
Yes, they very quickly discovered that in the first episode.
Okay, but before the contract signing, I mean.
No, they don't know that. So it may have been like a very small print somewhere in the contract.
Yeah, the EULA that nobody reads. Okay.
Yeah, it's just skipped. You know, just tick and skip.
Okay.
So yeah, and it is.
So okay. My question is basically. People have been doubting this as the new Queen's Gambit. How are we feeling about this on the levelness?
I haven't heard about this comparison, but actually coming into this, I was like, okay, well, how do I describe the show without spoiling it? And I would probably say that it's the best show I've seen since Queen's Gambit. Yes.
Okay. Okay.
I mean, there are some, like, amazing shows at Netflix, but they don't come up very often, you know? Every once in a while, you get a Queen's Gambit, and this is definitely another one. But the
really?
Fun part about it...
Wow.
Yeah, I would
okay.
say that it's great. Even though I haven't finished it, I hope that it ends in, a satisfying way. So many shows just can't finish gracefully. so many films as well. I don't understand what it is about finishing films, but I guess it's because maybe all the shows and films are now shot nowadays with hopes of like 20 sequels coming after.
Mm-hmm.
So they can't finish in like a satisfying arc. You
okay.
know, most of the time. Unless it's a limited series, which this isn't. And the director of the show said that he's not opposed to making season 2, whether it's going to be a sequel or a prequel, you know. I don't know.
Okay.
But yeah, it's very interesting. It's a very large-scale production. You have a ton of extras just working, you know, in the background because, of course, people have to get killed and, you know.
Yeah.
And it's all very graphic.
Yeah. Okay.
And yeah. Like, just the work they put into like shooting and choreographing the scenes is very fun. Of course, you know, as you can expect, I mean, spoilers, I guess, but you know, the number of people who are participating becomes smaller and smaller.
Mm-hmm.
With every game.
Okay, yeah.
And of course, it becomes more focused on the actual main characters. But yeah, it's all very fun. It's very anime.
Mm-hmm.
But not like in a way when you have an anime and they make a live action adaptation of the anime and it just doesn't work because, you know, anime can't like really be recreated in real world, you know?
Yeah.
Because
okay.
you can't really translate the same like over the topness of the anime into mm-hmm. like a live action film. But this is like a live action production that like channels like the spirit of anime, you know?
Mm.
So it feels correct. It's very
okay.
anime. It's very turned on. Okay. All right, Siri, come down. It's very anime. It's very video game. This is giving me huge probably obscure references, but this is like very Danganronpa and Nonary game. And also Hunger Games, if it's like a more popular culture references.
Yeah, I feel like also Hunger Games was the first thing that came to my mind also.
Also, you have PlayStation people who wear like triangles, squares, and circles on their
yeah,
heads.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And yeah, it's just so far I've seen we've seen 4 episodes out of 9.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
And it has been really quite brilliant, honestly.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah.
That's quite the praise, honestly.
It has a little bit of this kind of like... most shows are like that.
Mm-hmm.
Where, you know, we have this ensemble cast of characters who are like important to the story.
Yeah.
And then in a very video game fashion, they also have like a plot armor, you know? So
mm-hmm.
they all like... get through this together and they are, you know, in it. And so far this has been like, you know, consistent throughout the episodes. So just like the extras are the ones who are like, you know, dying left and right.
Yeah.
So it has this a little bit of like video gamey quality to it. But it's fun. I mean, the characters are fun. They are not very likable because, you know, basically everybody who gets into this game are, well, these people have issues, you know.
Yeah.
Basically, the idea is that they all have massive debts and they are entering the game to win and pay off the debts. So some of these are like gamblers, some of them are like stock investors who failed or lost all their money.
Yep. That makes sense.
You have all kinds of people. And what I also like about this show is that very unlike Western, especially American productions, you have so many actors who don't look like they came off the like Vogue magazine cover. You know, they look like just normal people, you know.
Okay.
Like you're run-of-the-mill normal yep. human person.
Yeah.
And it's very refreshing because, like, I feel like especially recently I've been noticing that I thought it was, at first I thought it was like the quality of teenage, like, drama, you know, melodramatic shows where, like, you know, it's high schoolers and all of them are hot. But
yeah.
I don't know, like, it's been the same in all recent shows that I've watched. And I mean, it's fine, you know, all the media has this thing, I guess, you know, this, like, over this obsession with like, you know, conventional like beautifulness, beauty.
Yeah.
So this show has like characters who look more like human beings. So
yeah,
I like that. You have old character, you have old people here. You have elder women here. You have like, yeah.
Okay.
All the Korean men in here. Well, the characters, I mean. Not like the actors.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's just been very refreshing. The fact that it's not also like an English language didn't. So it is available in an English dub. I have no idea how good it is. We are watching it in Korean with subtitles.
Okay. Yeah.
And yeah, it's just lovely. I really, really hope that the success of this film show. By the way, this is officially the most successful Netflix original production. Ever?
Really?
Yeah, 110 wow. million subscribers watched the show. Well, it's kind of hard to gauge because, you know, I don't really understand what Netflix understands as like watched, you know.
Yeah.
But yeah, no other show has had these numbers before.
Wow.
So I really hope that this will like inspire them to invest more money into like non-English speaking content and like the good stuff, not like, you know, I don't know.
Yeah. Wow.
Latin American and telenovelas and stuff.
That includes also, because that includes Stranger Things also then, I guess. Because
What do you mean?
Stranger Things was also a Netflix original, right? So.
Yeah. So it's, yeah, it's outdone with The Witcher, Stranger Things.
Wow.
Anything that you can think of. Yeah.
Damn.
Which is why it's so huge, because it is not an American or British, you know, show.
Yeah, that's also the, yeah, a lot of people have been also like, yeah, it's more like if it's good, it doesn't matter in which language it is, because for a lot of people this is a complete turn off if it's not in English. So I don't know. Yeah, some spoiled Americans, I guess they.
Yeah. I don't know. It hasn't been a problem at all. I mean, we watch like subtitles stuff all the time. You know, usually like Japanese like anime and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We always watch in like the original track with subtitles.
Yeah.
So it's not like a problem at all. But there's also so much, you know. There's so much like nonverbal acting happening that is just like, you know, the way they convey emotions and stuff like that is very like, you know, you can't like. Not understand this, you know, it's universal more or less in any language. So yeah, it's really, really good. I was thinking that it may have been like a, you know, a case when like social media picks it up and makes a big thing out of it and it's just like a mediocre show or something like that, but it's really quite something.
Wow. 111 million households watching the first 4 weeks. Bridgerton was the second.
I only heard about Bridgerton. I never
watched it. Yeah, I know.
So
yeah.
There you go. There's a top 10 also. What else is there?
Sweet Tooth, The Queen's. What? Okay. I was thinking Queen's Gambit would be would be higher up actually. Yeah, I Tiger King, I was expecting also to be on the list. No,
haven't seen Tiger King.
I haven't seen Tiger King also, and absolutely no idea what this is. Money Heist. Oh, okay, yeah. I've heard about it. Yeah, of course. Stranger Things also the sixth. Yeah, the Sex Life Lessons, blah. The Witcher. I have not heard about this. Lupin?
Oh wow. I've heard about the show, but I haven't seen it. It's quite high. Also like a random show, and also French, I think.
Yeah, I think this is this based on the... There was a movie. This reminds me of the movie a little bit, but this is probably nothing to do with the
there
movie.
There may have been a movie, but also it's based on a book, I believe.
Yeah.
Well, it's more like a contemporary interpretation of...
The hell? This is topping every single
by movie. A lot also.
By a not lot.
Like, not like by a million or two, but
yeah.
Like 30 million.
What the hell? I had no idea this was that big. Okay, what the hell?
Yeah.
And this just came out.
Yeah, totally.
Which
it's
is like
hot. It is number one in Estonia right now. I checked. Netflix shows like the most popular shows.
Holy.
Most popular content.
Okay.
And yeah, it is. Is really like, yeah.
Wow.
It is worth the hype. Well, I wasn't hype about it because I only heard about it on the internet. I was like, oh, everybody's watching the show, you know?
Yeah.
But like, I wasn't hyped by like outside sources about it. So I was like, I had no expectations about it at all. You know,
mm-hmm.
It was just kind of, and I was like, okay, well, let's just go into it. And
yeah.
It was just, yeah.
Damn. Now I kind of feel, yeah, now I'm kind of, my expectations have been upped. But yeah, we'll see.
It is.
If it's good, then it's good, right?
Yeah.
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 Okay.
I mean, when it's good, it's good. I feel like it also fits the October like release time.
Oh.
It's not like horror.
Mm-hmm.
But it also kind of is also, you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's not like a jump scare horror, but just more like a human horror.
Yeah.
Psychological horror, perhaps.
Mystery horror. Or
mystery, yeah. It's kind of like that genre.
Yeah.
But yeah, I think I'm going to just watch another episode today.
All right.
Honestly.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then, yeah.
All right, I'm playing Metroid Dread, I forgot to say.
Oh. Oh, yeah. People have been, saying Metroid Dread is actually... Okay, I'm gonna say what I have heard about it. People have been... Metroid Dread is the right name, right? Yes. On Switch, or what have you played? Or you have been...
Yeah, of course, it's a Switch exclusive
mm-hmm.
game.
Metroid Dread is okay. The only things I have heard about this game is it's actually hard, and that's why it's good. Those are the things I have heard basically, and people are basically really liking it that
mm-hmm.
for that reason.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess at first I should say that I have absolutely zero exposure to the series. It is like a little bit too old for me to be exposed
yeah,
to.
it was a Metro. Yeah, it was very very like SNES times basically like.
Yeah,
very,
the
very...
prime of the series was very that.
Yeah.
SNES, GBA, kind of like that era.
Mm-hmm.
And there hasn't been a new entry in a game in a decade, so I had
mm-hmm.
very limited opportunity to actually be experienced to it. So I was like, okay, well, I have also no expectations, and the genre isn't really something that I usually play, like a side-scrolling platformer action game. But
mm-hmm.
I was like, whatever. Of course, I knew what Metroid is, like as a series.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, okay, let's just go into it. I feel like people who played and enjoyed previous Metroid games will love the game. It is so well designed. So even I, as a like complete noob and a person who doesn't really understand the language of like a Metroid style game, where you like, you know, explore, and you can't really get everywhere, and then you get new powers, and then you can, you know, unlock the places that you previously couldn't. Even the game kind of like, it doesn't handhold you into showing you the correct path, but it also does a very good job of like funneling you toward it, sort of.
Mm-hmm.
In a way that you can never really feel like you are completely stuck, which is like very good. It has difficult sections in the game, yeah, and like you are right now watching one of them. This is a very big part of the game.
Damn it.
This is the part where you are like...
clicked away.
Basically, being chased by enemies that you cannot defeat.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like a more like hardcore-ish platforming section because you have to run and you have to do it in like a very specific way.
Mm-hmm.
And if you fail, you die basically. Yeah. So yeah, I guess the difficulty can come from that. The boss fights have been, some of them have been like difficult-ish, but not like super annoying. And the game is also very good at giving you checkpoints, so the checkpoint is always before the boss fight.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So you can just like go right back into it and just continue.
Yeah.
The story so far has been nonsensical. I don't really care about the story.
Mm.
It's like, as I understand, the entire story of the entire series is like her. Spoilers, I guess this is a woman like in the suit.
Mm-hmm.
I guess there are still people out there who don't know that, but yeah.
I knew
the main character.
I knew that actually. Yeah.
She basically like just travels around planets and does stuff, and in the end the planet explodes. That's basically the story for the entire series. So as far as I'm concerned, she's the villain of the series, you know.
Mm.
Because she just destroys every planet she goes to.
Okay.
Are we the real bad guys? Yeah, so that's basically that. The gameplay is very fun. Even though I find side-scrolling platformers quite boring quite quickly.
Okay.
Because they are just that most of the time. They're just side-scrolling platformers. And, you know, you play them for 3, 4, 5 hours. And it's like, you know, it feels like you've seen everything that you could. But this game constantly keeps adding new mechanics and mm-hmm. gives you new tools to traverse and, like, again, open new paths and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And it keeps it fresh.
Yeah.
And I think it's also quite short.
Okay, yeah.
Which is something that I heard people complain about.
Okay.
Actually, which is, I mean, yeah, there is this, like, thing in video games where like people think that every game needs to be like 50 hours long,
but they mostly are concerned about their value for their money, basically.
Yeah,
right?
totally. I mean, it is a $60 game, and if you spend $60 and you play for 10 hours,
mm-hmm.
I can understand how it can be, you know,
yeah,
it can be a little bit much.
Yeah.
And considering how rarely Nintendo games go on sale, you know, this game is going to be $60 today, a month from now, and probably like 6 months from now as well.
Mm-hmm.
So okay. It's just what it is.
Yeah.
But as I have less and less time to dedicate to playing video games,
yeah,
I have been very enjoying this game and knowing that I'm like, I think I'm like 7 hours in.
Okay.
And I'm like, ooh, like 3, 4 hours later, I'm going to finish this game. Well, not like completely, you know, because
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
you have upgrades and stuff that you can collect, but mm-hmm. there's like, just finish the story. And the thought is very comforting. Like, finishing games is fun.
Yeah.
And I like long games as well. I recently finished like an 85-hour long game.
Damn.
Which I also enjoyed.
Which one?
Oh, I talked about it, I think, once. Shadowverse RPG game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And yeah, I was quite hot on it as well, for people who like card games and who wish that Yu-Gi-Oh! Still had these like adventure card games.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I maintain that. I think the game is very good. It literally has no right to be as good as it is. Because it should be like a cheap cash grab, but it actually is a quite well-made game.
Okay.
But yeah, it took me like 85 hours to finish, you know, and I enjoyed it, you know, and the fact that I stuck with it for 85 hours probably says a lot. But I also can't like justify just playing these games because mm-hmm. I don't have as much time, and sometimes I like to finish games as well. So right now I'm finishing Metroid Dread, hopefully by the end of the week.
Yeah.
Hopefully I'll have time. And then my birthday is on Monday, so I'll get myself maybe Kina, Bridge of Spirits. We already talked about it last episode.
Yeah.
Which is also a short game.
Okay.
And I'll finish that as well.
Nice.
And I'll feel very good about myself.
Okay.
But yeah, Metroid Dread, I feel like there is no reason for fans of the series to not like this game.
Okay. So, $60 well spent.
Well, actually, we got it for less.
Oh.
Because Nintendo has a system, well, we have a UK account.
Ah.
Nintendo doesn't restrict credit cards or like debit cards by country, so you can register French, because like not all the countries are available to create accounts for in the Nintendo system. Like for example, Estonia is not a thing that you can create an account for.
Oh, okay.
So your choices are to do like Russia or UK or France or something like that, and like you should be able to use your card without any issues.
Oh, okay. So, so how much was it?
So they have a system that they have vouchers. If you subscribe to Nintendo Switch Online,
okay,
which costs €20 per year per person.
Okay, okay.
So not like that expensive. They offer vouchers.
Okay.
And these vouchers, you buy two vouchers, cost €95.
Okay.
And two vouchers allow you to buy two games. Not any game is eligible, but basically every game that Nintendo themselves publishes is a fair game. So,
okay.
Metroid is there, the Pokemon remake that is coming out next month is there, you know, all like the big Nintendo games are there.
So.
And so, yeah, so you get two vouchers for €95 and you redeem it for like a, you know, €60 game basically. So every game then becomes not €60, but
so it's 47.5,
yeah, something like that. So yeah, you save about 10-11 euros per game.
Okay, sounds good.
Which is, you know, at that point,
yeah,
this is probably what it's going to cost when it goes on sale eventually, you know, like 6 months after.
Yep. Yeah.
So yeah, we have actually been getting pretty much all Nintendo games that we are interested in. We have been buying with vouchers.
Nice. That's a good system.
They launched it in America at the same time, but they also ended it very quickly. But in Europe, it's been working for years at this point.
Okay.
So I definitely recommend for people who buy digital games and who are interested in like the big name, like Mario's are there, Zelda's are there, Pokemon, Metroid, Mario Kart, like all of this stuff will be there.
Yeah. One day I will maybe buy a Switch or a
Switch Pro
or a
Steam Deck.
Or the Steam Deck. Yeah, exactly. That's one, also one. I don't know. I have a hard time justifying like multiple playing platforms, basically. Like
totally.
If I have a PC, then yeah, but it's not out on the PC, so it's like
probably will never be out. Nintendo is very like very precious about their exclusive games.
Okay, but I think
just everybody go watch Squid Game, honestly.
Yeah.
Just like right now.
just tune off the show and go right now. Yeah. Oh, I think I will getting. I tried to squeeze that in. We want to finish Breaking Bad finally, and we're fourth season. It's five seasons total, and we're in the middle of the fourth one. And yeah.
All right.
And then probably Squid Game. How long are the episodes of Squid Game?
Oh yeah, I was about to say, they are approximately an hour long. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay.
50 to an hour.
Yeah, that's Breaking Bad is also an hour right now, so it's So it's it's one episode per day basically for us.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Yeah. Got it. All right. So. Thank you for tuning in into this lovely tech talk with us, and see you again next week, right?
Yeah, thanks everyone.
Peace out, and see you next week.
Yay.
Bye.
Bye.